Jesus, not the world, June 1.
Thou shalt not have in thy bag diverse weights, a great and a small. Thou shalt not have in thine house diverse measures, a great and a small. Deuteronomy 25, verses 13 and 14.
Those who profess to love and fear God should cherish sympathy and love for one another and should guard the interests of others as their own. Christians should not regulate their conduct by the world standard. In all ages, the people of God are as distinct from worldlings as their profession is higher than that of the ungodly. From the beginning to the end of time, God's people are one body. The love of money is the root of all evil. In this generation, the desire for gain is the absorbing passion. If wealth cannot be secured by honest industry, human beings seek to obtain it by fraud. Widows and orphans are robbed in their scanty pittance. The poor people are made to suffer for the necessaries of life, and all these that the rich may support their extravagance or indulge their desire to hoard.
The terrible record of crime daily committed for the sake of gain is enough to chill the blood and fill the soul with horror. The fact that even among those who profess godliness, the same sins exist to a greater or less extent, calls for deep humiliation of soul and earnest action on the part of the followers of Christ. Love of display and love of money have made this world a den of thieves and robbers, but Christians are professedly dwellers upon the earth. They are in a strange country, stopping, as it were, only for a night. They should not be actuated by the same motives and desires as are those who have their home and treasure here. God designed that lives should represent the life of our great pattern, that, like Jesus, we should live to do others good. Every wrong done to the children of God is done to Christ Himself in the person of His saints. Every attempt to advantage oneself by the ignorance, weakness, or misfortune of another is registered as fraud in the ledger of heaven. The Southern Watchman, May 10th, 1904.